Hey guys, what's up? I'm Palak Lakhani. In this channel, I make educational videos focusing mainly on studying, working and living in Germany. So if you are new here, consider subscribing. So in today's video, we have Nidhi Joshi with us. She completed her master's in medical imaging and data processing from FAU Erlangen. She is here to give you a detailed insight about her course. So let's get started with today's video. Hi Nidhi, welcome to my channel.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Could you please introduce yourself in detail?
Yeah, sure. So my name is Nidhi Joshi and I come from a town called Dharwad, which is in Karnataka state in India. And most of my schooling and education is done in Gujarat. I did my BTech from Nirmal University in instrumentation and control engineering. And after that, I did job for 1 year. Then I wanted to pursue masters because my main interest was machine learning and deep learning. So I was looking for courses in that direction. And then I applied to Germany, like a couple of universities. At that time, though I knew that I wanted to study machine learning and deep learning, but then I still tried to apply to other departments as well, because my background was instrumentation, so I could apply to mechanical, electrical, computer science.
So you had wide scope.
Yeah, wide scope.
Okay.
So I just applied to many universities. I can't even remember them now. But then finally I got something what I actually wanted to do.
Okay.
And I did my master's from FAU in the stream of medical engineering, and the particular course is called medical imaging and data processing.
Okay.
So I'm here since 2016. I finished my master's in December last year, and then I was also a victim of corona crisis. So but finally I managed to get a position of my interest now. 2 weeks back I started my PhD at Hamburg University, and the PhD is related to social psychology and human-computer interaction. So I'll be doing some virtual reality, augmented reality stuff based on social psychology.
Okay, wonderful.
Yeah.
Why would you suggest students to choose this particular course?
So as I said, I used to watch a lot of Andrew Ng's videos, Professor Andrew Ng's videos. And that's when I got interest in machine learning and deep learning field. Also, I have a strong research family background. My dad has done his PhD too from IIT Bombay, and he is a professor in DAICT, Sri Bhimani University in Ahmedabad. So he did his PhD in computer vision and image processing. So I sort of had it in the back of my mind that I should do something in this direction. But was not sure until my bachelor's was done, and then I was not liking my job after my bachelor's. But then I was very firm after that I want to do this this course. And coming to the question, I chose this course because it had something related to medical technology image processing and computer vision, machine learning, deep learning. So all these things were combined in that one course.
Okay.
And that was something of a great interest to me.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah, for people who want to do who want to study more about the instrumentation part of medical technology, I don't think this is a right course. If they're interested in the software part, then only they should come to this course.
Okay. What are the admission requirements for this course?
I think they're pretty much the same as the other universities. You require a strong motivational letter. You need a letter of recommendations from the from maybe your bachelor thesis supervisor or something. Then you need this application form filled, and then you need TOEFL, something to prove that you are good in English and good enough to understand what they teach in English. GRE, I think I had just submitted it, the heck of it, but it was not required.
Okay.
But then I did have an interview for this course.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and Professor Andreas Meyer, who's the head of Patent Recognition Lab, so he took my interview and then he asked me some basic questions about DSP. Like, I still remember he asked me about sampling theorem. Yeah, so the interview was like nice, but it was not totally non-technical. He did ask something technical. Yeah, not everybody gets this interview, but I don't know, like some batches get it and some just they are lucky.
Should a student apply? Is it via uni assist or directly to the university?
So there is a, it's not through uni assist. There is a portal called Campu.
Okay.
So it's through this portal.
Are the applications accepted? Are they in winter semester or in summer semester also?
Both the semesters they take students.
Okay. What are the course fees or the semester fees that you have to pay?
I think it keeps increasing every semester, but what I remember from the past, like the closest semester was 112 or something.
That's and pretty cheap.
Yeah, that's pretty cheap. And we have the transportation, I mean public transport benefits under that, but you are allowed to only travel from I think 7 p.m. to 6 a.m. in the morning with
okay.
that ticket. If you want like a whole day ticket, you have to purchase the additional one, which uh-huh. costs 200 euros.
Okay, good. What study areas and modules does a student learn in this particular course?
So like there are a lot of modules, there are 7 modules to complete this entire course, and in every module there are a lot of electives.
Yeah.
So you have to form your own course in which direction you want to move. You have to decide it for yourself. Like the first module, it focused mainly on medical physics and radiation therapy and like how to treat cancer related stuff and the different imaging modalities which are related to this.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Yeah, this stuff was there, and then there was some basic anatomy which we had to clear.
Okay.
Yes, of course there are a few courses which have to be done, like mm-hmm. this anatomy one. Then there are compulsory machine learning, deep learning related courses.
Okay.
That is called pattern recognition and pattern analysis. And apart from that, I also took some imaging courses, that is that they are called diagnostic medical image processing and interventional medical image processing.
Okay.
And so these like go into depth of all the imaging modalities like X-ray, CT, MRI, how the image processing is done for each of them, reconstruction of the CT images, etc., and also image fusion and so on.
Okay.
So these courses were not compulsory, though it is medical imaging course, but I did take them because it would be like it's a good thing for the entire course. There are a few courses like biosignal analysis where they do like in-depth study about the different biosignal ECG,
okay.
EMG, etc. Again, this was something which I chose.
Okay.
We did not choose those, but just to give a basic idea of the entire course. Mathematics is involved, like optimization for engineers. This course, I think it's better if you take it, be good for you. And then engineering mathematics. Yeah, so I forgot to mention this. There were two conditional subjects.
Okay.
So the admission that I got was not a confirmed one. I had to finish two conditional subjects, and only after that I would be like
given admission.
Admission. And I was given 1 year to finish these two courses.
Okay.
They are advanced programming and engineering maths.
Okay.
So advanced programming was not a cakewalk. It's a little bit difficult one, and engineering mathematics was still okay. You can do it with your BTech knowledge.
Okay.
Yeah, so I finished these courses in the first semester itself because there was a burden of finishing it within 1 year, and if you don't, you have to go back or look for another course somewhere else in Germany. Yeah.
Okay. How are the exams conducted? Like, are there oral exams, written exams, MCQs or presentations?
There are oral exams, written exams. There were no MCQs in the courses I took. There were a few seminars.
Okay.
Yeah.
Which softwares would you recommend students to learn before taking an admission to this course, and which softwares do you learn after getting an admission?
So I think I just knew MATLAB before coming here, but if the person knows Python, MATLAB, C++, and many variants now, Java, etc., It's always good. But it's good to know at least one language.
Okay.
Afterwards, I work mainly with Python. I was working on machine learning applications, sorry, deep learning applications, so I worked with Keras and Tensor.
What research facilities and laboratories does FAU Erlangen have?
So I think the research facilities are really fantastic. So they have a Informatic 5 pattern recognition lab. And I also used to interact with the PhD students very often and look into what work they are doing. So they had project related to mammography images classification using deep learning. They work mainly with the images. There were some historic images as well. They were working with some kind of object recognition. And apart from the university, they have collaborations with UniClinicum. Because it's a medical based course, they have collaborations with UniClinicum. And I worked there as well. So I did my master thesis there. Then the city has a lot of student jobs to offer. So I worked in the university first, and then as a tutor for some course, and then after that I worked with the UniClinicum for some time. I worked with Siemens Healthineers for some time, and then for like 1 or 2 months I worked with Fraunhofer as well.
Great.
Yeah, so a lot of opportunities are there for students, which is very good. Yeah.
Is there a mandatory internship for students in this course?
So there is no mandatory internship, but you have to complete some research project as a part of M6 module.
Okay.
So that's what I completed with the PR lab, mm-hmm. the mammography image classification.
Okay.
Yeah, you have to do that, but there is no mandatory internship as such, where you have to find something outside the university.
What resources did you use to find your thesis?
To find my thesis, so I think I looked for a couple of other theses also before that. I went to a doctor and he had some data to work with, but then somehow it didn't work out. And then I went, since I had performed very well on one subject in my second or third semester, after which I had got a student job there as a tutor. Because of this, I was included in some email chain of the department. So whatever new opportunities used to pop up, they used to get forwarded through those emails. And then I used to contact the responsible person, and then I got it in UniClinicum.
Okay, great. Yeah. Towards the end, what would you suggest are the future scopes after the completion of this degree, and what is the expected salary that a student can earn?
Okay, so the future scope, I have to say it from my point of view, because I am a victim of the corona crisis. It was a little bit difficult. I wouldn't say it was very difficult. So the scope, like in a normal scenario, would be pretty much good, I feel. But I did face some problems because I initially got a job offer from a startup in Sweden. And then I took it up, I got my visa and everything done. But after that, the corona crisis hit, and then the company didn't really call me there. Then after that, I wanted to go for a job, but then since it was somewhere in the back of my head that PhD was also not ruled out option for me because I have a strong background. I started applying for PhDs, and in PhDs, it was pretty good, because I feel that the university had made my medical base really strong, so I could face the interviews pretty well. I got 5 offers, I think, in total. And then this one, the one related to social psychology, I chose as a PhD topic because I was always interested in this kind of stuff from the beginning. And now that I got a chance to work with it, it was really great opportunity.
Okay.
And regarding the salary, I'm not the right person to ask this. Yeah. Because I just heard it from my seniors that in Bavaria, it depends on what role you're applying for and what place you're staying.
Okay.
So accordingly, your salary will be there. But I think it's around 40 to 50K per year.
Yeah.
In Bavaria, at least you can expect that. And for PhD, I'm not sure exactly how much. I'm not even sure how much I'll be paid.
Okay. Great. So thank you so much, Nidhi, for this detailed interview.
Yeah.
And I hope you find this interview really useful. And if you like the video, then please share it with your friends. And also don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And also consider subscribing to my channel. See you in the next video, guys. Till then, bye. Take care and stay safe.
Bye.